Hello everyone, today we will learn how to use fillets in surfacing in Petya viewfinder. So let us start with the generative shape design. And now we will create a feature here. Let's have a rectangle so that now you can see that this is only one surface. You can add an edge fillet to here. So just select the edge, add the fillet, and OK. So for edge fillet, only the edge required. You can select the selection mode here, tangency. Maximum you can provide, go with the minimal. If you want to modify, again double click on this edge fillet. And now if you don't want to trim the support, just uncheck this option and then click OK. So the fillet is added. That here is the fillet is added, and these supports are remain as it is. So if you want to keep the support, you have to uncheck this trim support, and if you click that, then the support is going to trim here. Then here is the caudal fillet. Here also select the edges to fillet. Just select the edge and add the caudal length. Then click OK. Again here also, if you want to keep the support, will click with you and OK. So these are the similar options when we are using the part design. So this is a caudal fillet. Again you can make a tangency here and in support. So in this way you can select the caudal fillet. Then we will see the face fillet. So here again select the two faces, select face 1, face 2. That is, you can select the two surfaces here and then click to just add the radius. Let's suppose 10 mm. You can add this face fillet also. So now then we will trim this surface. Here you need to select each edge, you need to select here. Close that. Now again, this is a separate, these two are the separate surfaces. We will provide a a variable fillet here. We just create the edges to fillet. And then we need to first join this with the join command. Join these two surfaces. Now you can see this surface is single surface. Now create a variable radius definition. Just create the edge, select the edge. It will select it as a tangency continuity. Reduce this to minimum. Keep on tuning. See that. Now again, here we can add a multiple points to add a variable radius there. So just add these points. Click on this icon. Just select the point. So for the closed sketches, we don't have access to add a variable points here. So we only need to select the only one point. So but if we use so let's suppose if we delete this and then so I will just all the children here. So if you want to provide a variable radius, just click on the variable. Now for this is open, so open sketch, so we can provide the multiple points here. Just click on that icon and then add a multiple points in between and then add a radius, variable radius from the graphics window itself. 25 mm. And then you can select a preview. Now again, there is an option that is trim support. So you can create a variable radius definition. So that the first surface we can have. And then you can see this the variable radius. So now we'll see the shape fillet is a very important fillet used in Patia surfacing. So to use this shape fillet, we first delete this. So we have to use this shape fillet and extrude that. So just select the shape fillet. So here you need to add this support 1. So select support 1 and support 2. So it creates a fillet in the quadrant where this arrow is showing. So select these two surfaces and click on preview. So here it is added a fillet. Let's suppose if I change the direction, to change the direction of this arrow, double click on this arrow, it will change the direction. If you change the direction, then the fillet will occur inside. And if you just double click on it to change the direction, then this radius will be formed outside this cylinder. So in this way, these directions are important, and in between, toward the direction, it will form a radius. So again, you can add a radius here. If you have the chordal length, then you can select this chordal length, and then preview, add the appropriate length, and then click preview. So in shape fillet, basically this shape fillet is used to trim the two intersected surfaces and add fillet at the intersection, add fillets at the intersection. So this arrows again, maintain a very important role in shape fillet. So the shape fillet means trim with a fillet. Okay. So it is similar to trim, but it adds a fillet itself in one command. So it is very important. As the tree becomes less bulky in surfacing, so in this way you can use the fillets. There are lot of fillets there, so we use this fillet mostly. So please subscribe my channel and like my videos. If you have any queries, comment below. I will definitely try to solve each of them. Thank you for watching.